2014 brought with it a rather unexpected announcement. Not only were we getting a new Battlefield game, but it would also be one not developed by DICE, instead with Visceral Games entering their first game to the series, with their Cops and Robbers experience Hardline. This was a large departure from the more serious entries of the main title Battlefield games, but unfortunately this more light-hearted take on Battlefield never quite captured the community as the previous games had. But we'll be covering all of that as I revisit Battlefield Hardline. I won't lie, I have been wanting to use this theme song for a very long time. Hi there everyone, I'm the guy with no gamertag, and to get the usual housekeeping out of the way, this video will contain spoilers, so if you haven't played the single player yet, do look out for the graphics you're seeing at the bottom of the screen, and they will notify you of which bits you can skip. And this game is going to be a slightly unusual one in this particular series. When I first played it, I wasn't majorly impressed by it. The game made some interesting quality of life improvements, and it had a decent single player. But overall, my opinions of the multiplayer meant that I really felt rather indifferent towards this game. It never grabbed me like Battlefield 3 and Battlefield 4 had. So when I came back to play this, I wasn't expecting too much of it. But my goodness, my opinions have changed considerably, especially with regards to the single player. So let's take a look at that first. The game set in Miami immediately throws you into a police raid with Stoddard, which turns into an absolute mess of a car chase. It's a very sharp, concise, and very action-oriented introduction that really gets the player into the game and gets them into the action straight away. And I think it was really effective. Not only does it have an introduction with the banger of a song Karma by Jamie and Commons to it, but it also just throws the player in the deep end straight away into a setting which is perfectly familiar for this genre, a police raid and a drugs bust. This is exactly what we've seen in many TV shows and movies in the past where it's a cops and robbers theme. It was absolutely a perfect introduction. You then get to meet Dawes, the police captain, and your new partner, Kai. And the game really just throws players into somewhere that's familiar, whilst also creating its own story around it. The opening missions with Kai allow you to get some banter between the two characters, get to understand them a bit more, and give you a bit more exposition, but also then introduces you to the more police-oriented mechanics, where you can arrest suspects and collect bounties from certain arrests, before you eventually end up in a firefight. And it keeps the game moving and also introduces little bits of variety. Whereas you start off with the stealth oriented, where you're trying to sneak into a criminal hideout and arresting people, then when things go south, you've then got a gunfight and a rapid escape. It's just that correct progression of mechanics where it keeps the player engaged, and I found it really enjoyable. But then later on, you end up in missions such as the Everglades, where the game slows down quite a lot more. It gives the player a considerable amount of freedom as to how they pursue this particular mission. There's various different bases around this area as you're trying to identify where the drugs are coming from. This was interesting. It gave the game a lot more chance to have dialogue between Mendoza, the character you play as, and your partner Kai, to try and understand their motivations, who they are a bit more, and it really gave you a bit more of a sense of who their characters are whilst you go through various bases of criminals. It was a decent mission, but it definitely relied very heavily on stealth, and that's one of the things that this game does quite often. And to an extent, it does make sense within the theme. Even in a light-hearted cops and robbers style game, being the police officer, you're not going to want to shoot if you can avoid it. You're intended to arrest criminals rather than have major shootouts, even though the game does give you some structured areas where that is meant to be the case. But this does lead to the problem where you are playing for stealth for quite a lot, and it perfectly makes sense within the story. There's absolutely no dissonance between what the game is showing you and what you're doing. The problem is, when you have stealth for so long in a game, unless it's adding in new mechanics gradually throughout it, it gets a bit frustrating and it gets a little bit boring because you're still doing the same thing over and over again in just a slightly different setting. And whilst in this game, I felt that the mechanics made it interesting enough to where it wasn't a problem, I found that the amount of stealth in this game really put a time limit on the amount I could play it, because if I played it for too long, I would eventually get bored of the primarily stealth gameplay. But that being said, the game does break it up a bit and give you a bit of variety. You've also got your cop chases, you've got major busts where you can go loud, and you've got large-scale firefights, a little bit of wave defense, and all those standard first-person shooter mechanics, which just break it up a bit, give you a bit more variety, but still fit the theme in my opinion. And alongside this, the game also had a sort of collectibles and progression system, where when you arrest criminals or you get certain bounty criminals where you've either searched their body or just managed to arrest them, then you get extra XP, and you can also gain evidence for case files, which then give you access to new weapons. And that was one of the main aspects of this game, was kind of like Battlefield 4, you can kind of customize and curate your loadout. When you've unlocked various weapons, you can then access them and use them whenever you really want to. You could go from your everyday B-cop loadout, where you've just got a taser and a baton. All the way up to excessive force with an M16 and a 44 Magnum. All the way up to, there ain't gonna be a Third Amendment. But there was one thing that was slightly wrong with this, was that in order to unlock these new weapons and complete the case files and get these assignments done, you had to take down or arrest suspects rather than shooting them. You never got awarded points for shooting enemies, which did kind of make sense on both sides, because of course if you're a police officer, you don't want to be shooting people unnecessarily, and as a criminal, you don't want to be shooting because it will draw the police towards you. So it did make sense within the theme of the game. But the problem being that you are rewarded for not shooting people with equipment that makes shooting people a lot easier and a lot more fun. So there's kind of this tug of war of the mechanics don't quite make sense with each other. I think it would have been better in a hypothetical reboot of this game, where if you would take down a certain number of people non-lethally and arresting them, then it would give you some optional missions where you could then use some of this equipment and it was perfectly fine. You have like major drug busts. Or maybe you take the role of a sniper in a hostage situation. I think that would have made a lot more sense than this system, because the reward for being a good cop or being a quiet criminal was to be a bad cop or a loud criminal, and it just didn't really make sense. And the other main criticism I had of the single player was that whilst the car chases did help add in the variety and break up the frequent use of stealth in the game, the driving physics in this game were absolutely awful. The cars have no weight to them, and it really broke that immersion. I'm absolutely fine with having a crazy cop chase. I mean, I had no problems with the fact that my revolver all of a sudden gained infinite ammo midway through one of these chases. That didn't bother me. It was just the fact that the cars felt so un-car-like and it had no challenge to the driving. Just meant that I never enjoyed those parts. They were fun in terms of the spectacle of them, but to actually play through, they really were not enjoyable. But the thing that really has changed my opinions of this game from when I originally owned it and played it was actually just the story and the characters. The story starts out with your character Mendoza being the new guy trying to earn his stripes, being allocated a new partner Kai, with whom you start to open up a major drug ring, eventually finding out that Stoddard's a dirty cop, and having doors the police chief get you framed and thrown in jail. Kai then breaking you out, and you're now a criminal crew going on a revenge tour to try and take down doors, with an ending which is absolutely perfectly open-ended for players to interpret what Mendoza did with the contents of Dawes' vault. At the end of the day, the story the game follows isn't revolutionary. I wouldn't say it's anything more than a pretty standard cops and robber style story, but it was just the delivery and the dialogue within the game was absolutely fantastic. Whether it's just offhand dialogue between the characters in some of the slower parts of the game, or some of the bantering between your crew later in the game, or even just some of the crazy slapstick humour in this game, it's just absolutely nailed it. The script writing and the voice talent performance in this game were absolutely fantastic, and they absolutely nailed what this game was just trying to be, which was an entertaining cops and robbers game. And I love it for that. It's crazy, it's funny, it can be serious at times without being a joke, and it's just a perfect delivery of a cops and robbers story in my opinion. If I had to sum the game up in a singular sentence, it would actually be in two words. Entertaining bullshit. The game is crazy. It's off the rails at times, but it's just so much fun to play through because of the character interactions, the overall story, and the crazy things the game does get you to do. But at the end of the day, Battlefield has been mostly a multiplayer franchise, and the single players have never really been the sole focus of the game. And Hardline was no exception. But unfortunately, this was where the game really started to lose me and didn't grab me as much as Battlefield 3 and Battlefield 4 did. And there was one real problem for that. A singular word kind of damned this game in a way, which was Battlefield. The game did a great job of creating a cops and robbers story in the single player, but in the multiplayer, it was completely held back by the constraints of being a Battlefield game, having the classes and their different roles added into the game, the various map design, and trying to make modes that were similar to those things experienced in previous Battlefields, rather than just owning it and going all in with the cops and robbers theme. It meant that there was a game design that just didn't really make sense, and it didn't really work in my personal opinion. If I was to give you an example, I played a lot of the heist mode when this game was out, because it was very similar to the rush mode, which I loved in Battlefield 3 and Battlefield 4. The criminals have to break into a vault and steal some cash, and then have to get this cash to an exfil location, whereas the police have to try and stop them stealing the cash. But where the game design issues come into it is that at the very beginning of the round, both teams start very close to the vault. The criminals get there a little bit sooner, and then the police can arrive and try and stop them. But the problem being is that after this initial firefight, both teams spawn miles away from the vault. Like, no joke, they spawn ages away, because it's got the base mechanics that you have in Battlefield games. And this really let it down, because then if you failed this first push, or you just happen to get killed, oh, have fun, you've now got a 5-minute walk back to the objective and back to the action. And it meant that whereas you had some really fun, chaotic firefights right at the beginning, the game instantly slowed down. It felt very difficult for the criminal to then get back to the vault to try and steal the cash to have one of those entertaining firefights again. And on the other side, it also felt difficult for the police to get to the vault or to get to one of the drop-off locations to stop them exfilling. Because it was a Battlefield game, it had to try and cater to the Battlefield audience. Whereas if it had just been Hardline or had its own name, it could have committed harder to having the cops and robbers style gameplay. And I believe that would not only have made it a more entertaining experience, but it would have felt like it was designed for it. Whereas this game, it kind of feels like it was slapped together. And that's no disrespect to Visceral Games. I know that the problem here was because they were trying to make a Battlefield game was the problem. I feel that that was what really held this back, rather than it being a just complete screw up. And the game also has some weird hit registration. I will preface this by saying that when I go back and play it, there are not many servers left on this game, which is a bit of a shame, because especially when people do enjoy playing it, it is a shame to see a game become so unpopular. But the one thing I didn't expect to see in 2021, there were people boosting in Battlefield Hardline. Like, there's probably less than 20 servers which have a decent amount of players in them, and yet one of them is for players to boost in? I don't get that. This game is 6 years old and there were people boosting in it. Like, I suppose if you feel like you're useless, remember that there are people that are out here boosting in Battlefield Hardline in 2021. But because of the overall lack of populated servers, especially in the EU region, meant that when I revisited it, I did spend a lot of my time in United States servers. So obviously that's going to make my ping a lot worse and make the hit registration worse. But something I did notice consistently when I used to have it and when I went back and playing it was that you quite often felt like you as a player would die instantaneously, and then you would hear the gunfire from the other player. You'd be dead and then you would see the muzzle flash. You'd be dead and then you'd hear the gunfire, and it never really made sense. It never gave the players time to react. And I always felt like the game was one or two patches behind Battlefield 4 in terms of the netcode improvements the game had made. It did feel very much a bit like the pre-patch Battlefield 4 version, where you would just instantly die. And I feel like also the game had a slower muzzle velocity on a lot of the weapons, which also does not help for hit registration. If your bullets are traveling much slower than in games that you're used to, it just makes it a lot harder to hit your targets. Also, there were some weapon balancing problems. This has been well documented, but the TLDR is, you've got weapons like the M16 and the M416, which have very low recoil and have really good damage, which outclasses pretty much every weapon. These were the best weapons in the game, hands down, but they weren't satisfying to use because there was no difficulty in handling them. Whereas when you look at a weapon class like the battle rifles, these weapons had incredible amounts of recoil, but had insanely high damage and really beefy sounds to them. It meant there was kind of like a discontinuity between the weapons that were really satisfying but really hard to use, and the weapons that were just easy but kind of bland and boring. And it meant that overall in this game, I always struggled to find a flow, especially on maps like Bank Job. I kind of understand why people like it, because it's close quarters, it's very fast-paced action, but they just felt like there was no flow to it. I could very rarely get into a rhythm, and that was something that also put me off on this game, was I never quite felt like I got in a zone. I never quite enjoyed playing the multiplayer in this, which was a shame, because going back and playing the single player, I'd have loved to have loved this game. I like the character, and that's the thing the game has more than anything, is personality and character. All the little Easter eggs they had in the game, where when you're reloading a deagle, it would disappear and then your character would do a magic trick to pull it back. Or even the American Dream sofa that you could drive around in Hotwire. That kind of stuff was hilarious. It was fantastic. It gave the game so much personality. But unfortunately, the gameplay and multiplayer just never quite matched up to it. It never grabbed me. And that is unfortunately why this game still isn't very popular, and it's why that there are such dwindling player numbers, is there's a certain crowd that loved it. And that's great. I am happy for anyone who does. But for me, and I think for the wider Battlefield community, it just suffered from being called a Battlefield game. If it had been able to just own it and just go straight in as a cops and robbers only game, it would have probably been a way more entertaining experience. But unfortunately, that one word really did let the game down. Overall, I did really enjoy going back and playing this. Replaying the single player was one of the most pleasant surprises I've had for a long time when playing a game. I didn't expect to enjoy it as much as I did, but my god, the performances, the dialogue, the story, and the overall personality of the single player was absolutely worth going back to. In my opinion, if you can get this game for less than 10 quid, it's worth it for the single player. If you have EA access, I'd recommend downloading it and trying the single player. It's a good bit of fun. As I've said, the mechanics aren't perfect, it's a bit too emphasis on stealth, but the dialogue and the overall character and personality of the game really is worth playing, because it will just be entertaining, it will make you laugh, and that's what makes this game stand out. But I'm interested to hear what you all think of this. I feel like a lot of people will have similar experiences where they played previous Battlefield games but never quite were grabbed by the multiplayer of this one. But I'd be really interested to see how people who loved playing this game and why they enjoyed it as much as they did. But anyway, I do hope you've enjoyed this video. I've been the Guy with No Gamertag, and I'll see you on another video.